BBC Radio Scotland.
And now we catch up with a high-speed chase in progress, featuring a police response unit on the tail of what's been described as one of the biggest menaces facing Scottish society today. A bus full of football fans.
Sarge, we've honed in on the bus with the suspected criminal activity.
We can hear merriment, eyeball on colours. We can see scarves and flags.
We believe suspects to be in possession of a carry-out.
Any sign of a substantial meal?
Negative on that, Sarge.
All right, I'm making the call. Storm the bus. Let's teach these football fans a lesson.
Yes, Sarge!
Everybody down! We believe this bus to be a clear and present danger.
Down! Oh, God!
What is it, DCI? Is it an OCG, organised crime gang?
Oh, it's an OCG, all right. It's an open can of Guinness.
What do you football fans on a bus have to say for yourselves?
Football fans? We're off to the rugby.
Oh, rugby.
Oh, well, that's all right then.
Aye, you're free to go.
You lads enjoy the game.
Cheers. Thank you.
Cheers. Yeah, thank you. Hey.
Thanks, chaps.
Okay, settle down, S2. Could you please all turn to page 37 of your textbooks?
Miss, the left wall of the classroom has just collapsed, Miss.
Yes, I can see that, Kirsty. Thank you for that valuable insight. Now, could you all please complete exercises 4.1 to 4.6?
Miss, I can see Miss McLaughlin knitting, Miss.
Concentrate, John. Your eyes should be on your work.
Miss, the right wall of the classroom has just collapsed, Miss.
Thank you, Kirsty. I do have eyes, you know.
It's raining, Miss. I'm getting wet.
Then put your coat on, Layla. Everyone, please, focus.
Miss,
the front wall of the classroom has just collapsed. Yes, Kirsty. Now, can you please... Wait. Is that Grant Cunningham? I can see you, caught red-handed smoking behind the building. Get yourself to the headmaster's office.
Miss, the...
Derek Doyle. That's enough interruptions. Stand and face the wall.
Half the wall's away, miss.
Then face what's left of the wall. Okay, S2. New class project. The shoddy quality of building materials used in the UK between the 1950s and the 1990s. I'm expecting excellent submissions. You couldn't be better placed to study it firsthand.
The Scottish Parliament has just installed CCTV in the Holyrood lifts, capturing exchanges like this.
Hamza?
Running the line this weekend, Douglas.
Yes. Hopefully it'll go better than my last blimping game. Got mixed up during a match between Ross County and Motherwell. Instead of calling for VAR, I called for a police inquiry. Stopped the match for 3 days.
Good.
Patterlingo, from the people who helped you half understand 5 sentences in French.
Merci beaucoup.
As well as about 6 words in Spanish.
Grâce arse.
Now comes a new specialised linguistic learning experience, Patterlingo Ayrshire. Immerse yourself in the native tongue of the Gateway to Arran and even show off your local geography knowledge by using the same sound repeatedly.
Air.
Which translates as, there's air over there.
Air.
Patterlingo Ayrshire helps you express your feelings when hearing another one of your elderly relatives is unwell.
Oh, no, no, my nan in at all.
Oh, no, not my nan in as well now.
Oh, no, no, my nan in at all now.
And for agricultural matters in cold weather, subscribe to Patterlingo Premium Ayrshire Advanced.
Thank you for that. How can Gaza bogey to the morn's mall?
Learn what that actually means in 15 easy lessons. So, whether you wish to learn the language of love and become a master of Hochma Gandhi like Robert Burns, or just want to translate the insults hurled at Somerset Park every Saturday, yeas daily, and say, it's your sale to Patrilingo Ayrshire.
And at Holyrood, the Scottish Government announced policy priorities focusing on supporting children and young people.
Hear that, Gran? That's a good thing for the young generation, isn't it?
Ugh, you kids have it so easy nowadays with your government initiatives and your fast foods. You know, back in my day, we didn't have Pizza House and Kirkcaldy fried chicken. We had to ration our meals.
I know, Gran, that must have been hard, but people still struggle these days. That's why we need free school meals.
Oh, free school meals? You know, the only free school meals we got was the gum stuck to the underside of our desks.
Okay, Gran.
Don't get me started on these iMobiles that you kids have.
Well, they hadn't been invented yet.
All we had to keep ourselves occupied was our imagination and our whooping cough. And you young ones are staying at home far later than we ever did, huh? I moved out of my mother's house at 15 with nothing but a comb and a tin of shoe polish. And I was a homeowner by my 16th birthday.
How much did it cost you to buy your first house again?
2 shillings and 6 pence.
What would that be in today's money, Gran?
£47.50, aye. And you young pups today, you don't know the value of money. Now, just you hurry up and set up the remote for my brand new massive telly and I'll give you tuppence out my super generous pension.
Monsieur Macron, we must destroy 200 million euros worth of wine at once or the sector could collapse.
Oh, say no more. Send them in.
Drink!
The Minister will see you now, Miss Braverman.
Ah, Suella, good morning. What can I do for you?
Rishi, I've just had the most amazing brainwave on how to finally stop the boats.
Really? Finally stop the boats? How?
Get Calmac to run them.
Genius!
Yes, I thought so.
Massive controversy at today's Old Firm match, with Rangers having a goal disallowed. Let's finally settle the issue with extensive match analysis from the unbiased professional opinions of our pundits, an ex-Rangers player and an ex-Celtic player. Ex-Rangers player, was it a foul?
No.
Ex-Celtic player, do you think it was a foul?
Aye.
Well, there you have it. Coming up later tonight, tune in for our animal debate when we ask a cat owner and a dog owner to settle once and for all which is the better pet.
Tonight, after the 10 o'clock news, the wall of many newsreaders in the nations and regions suddenly becomes one newsreader. And it's me, Anne McAlpine on Reporting Scotland. A statement on RAC has been made by the UK government. It's incredibly weak, full of holes, and likely to collapse at any time. And the concrete is pretty dodgy too. Scottish Secretary Alistair Jack has called for the new Indiana Jones film to be pulled from Scotland cinemas. He claims repeated use of the word indie amounts to nationalist propaganda. Anne McAlpine, Reporting Scotland.
Welcome back. I'm pumped to introduce our next guest, who went viral in 2020, but is now planning a comeback. Please welcome to the studio, Coronavirus!
Hello again, everyone.
Now, a familiar name around the scene for all of us. How are you doing today, Coronavirus?
I'm great, thanks. Yeah, loving the lack of ventilation in here.
Amazing! Now, you've got a new variant which is out now. Tell us a little bit about it.
So it's titled BA.2.86, although my agent wants me to call it Parola. It's more experimental than my previous work. There are 35 mutations and you will know all about it when they drop because they are infectious.
Fantastic. Well, I mean, if anyone knows how to engage an audience, it's Coronavirus. Christmas 2020 really blew up for you, didn't it?
Yeah, it popped. It was huge. Coronavirus was everywhere. Everyone was talking about what I was going to do next, you know. I didn't expect to be headlining 2 years in a row, but to be honest, it was kind of easy.
especially with all those humans in charge having parties.
Now, listen, I have to ask about, well, the beef between you and influenza.
No, I mean, that's all good, you know. There's a lot of mutual respect. Obviously, iFlu's been in the game a long time and we've both been hit by a few jabs, but we're bouncing back and you ain't heard the last of us.
Well, a big thanks to you, coronavirus. New release is on the rise now. Up next, fresh from making waves at beach parties up and down the UK coastline, it's E. Colo. After the success of the football team, for those who identify as obese men, comes a new sporting initiative for blokes who may suffer from the stigma of being a bit on the thin side. So if you're a man with a waist size of 30 inches or less, come and join Darts for Skinny Men, an Arrows team created specifically for males struggling with their twiggy bodies.
At first, I wasn't sure about Darts for Skinny Men, but I've already gained 6 stone and a new sense of self-confidence. I've said goodbye to Mr. Pipe Cleaner Arms and I feel no more daddy long-legged skinny-malinky embarrassment. I've learnt new skills like how to throw darts and eat crisps at the same time. And my days of dodging raindrops are over.
Darts for Skinny Men. A moment at the hockey, a lifetime getting stocky.
Hey, I'm Meghan Markle, Duchess, content creator, global inspiration and mom. Now it's time for me to return to acting. At first I was skeptical, but Hollywood producers and casting directors got in touch by the truckload, saying they were blown away by a recent public performance. Yeah, the moment I told William and Kate, it was nice to see them. If I can deliver that convincingly, I can deliver anything. Click and subscribe for Tinseltown updates and news of which podcasts me and Harry are ditching.
Sad news, everyone. The inventor of Adobe PDF passed away this weekend.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm signing the sympathy card in his memory.
Good luck. That sympathy card is read-only.
Good. Good. Good morning. Well done, Scottish Government. A good turnout for our indie rally. 25,000 outside the Scottish Parliament. That's 24,900 more than turned up for that Graham Linehan gig. Good.
Yeah, we sure told them, Hamza. We spread our message that independence is normal. Hey, Patrick.
Too right, Lawrence. Both Green co-leaders held an end on a banner that said, independence is normal.
Yes, because nothing convinces people something is normal more than telling them it is normal in massive letters. That is perfectly normal.
Good point, Kate Forbes. Not picking up any sarcasm nor passive aggression there whatsoever. And I held up my own good banner saying, believe in Scotland. See, I believe in you, and I believe Scotland will believe in us. Especially when, in your head, you hear believe in the Cher voice.
Believe in the Cher voice?
Believe in Scotland.
Did the government sanction the expense of that auto-tuner?
Chill. It was a personal purchase for the karaoke nights at the Butte. Sounds good, eh? If Cher can make a comeback, so too can the indie movement. Do we all believe?
No.
Good. Something to work with there.
Bzz, can I have a shot? If that's those blimping SNP canvassers again, I already blimping said we have no truck with their blinking... Oh, is that a jet plane?
Hello, Douglas.
Prime Minister, you're here. And Murray, are you lost?
No, Douglas. I'm glad I caught you. I was on my way to Balmoral and this is on the way.
Oh, is it on the way, PM?
Douglas, everywhere's on the way when you travel by private jet. It fits snugly on your lawn.
So it does. I was meaning to get that gnome replaced.
And since I'm in the northeast of Scotland, I thought I might finally try a buttery. I'm in the mood for a creamy mint.
That's a roll, PM.
A what?
A buttery is what we call a flat bread roll, PM.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
I think so, PM. I've been eating butteries long enough.
How quaint. Tell me, are butteries ever called breadies?
No. Rowies sometimes, rolls, of course, or Aberdeenshire rolls. I might have heard BAP on occasion, but never bready. Sorry.
Right. Anyway, Doug, I'm en route to Balmoral and I need your assistance.
Me? Balmoral?
Thinking of the lay of the land, your knowledge and expertise could be invaluable.
Wow. You wish for me to accompany you to Balmoral, PM?
Oh, heavens no. We're about the same size. I was hoping I could borrow a pair of your wellies. I hear it gets marshy and I've only packed Gucci slip-ons.
Of course, PM. Marshed up Gucci's would be a blimping nightmare, I'd imagine.
Quick smart, good chap. Such an exciting trip to Balmoral. I wonder which actor will eventually play me in The Crown.
There's a question, PM. I wonder who'll play me. Martin Compston, James McAvoy, Michael Sheen.
They usually just stick to the important people.
Of course, PM. I'll get the wellies.
Pop them in the hold. I'll be in my jet. Good morning and boof! You're watching The Sunday Show with me, Martin Geisler, and joining me on BBC Radio Scotland and BBC Sounds, it's Fiona Stalker. What's the inside scoop on the upfront and coming, Fiona?
Morning, Martin. Yes, indeedy. Yes, indeedy. Paul McCartney's legendary bass guitar is missing. The iconic instrument Macca played on classics like Love Me Do and She Loves You.
Beatles fans have launched a worldwide hunt to return the bass, so long as he doesn't use it to write any more new solo stuff. Ba-boof! At a pro-independence rally, 25,000 people gather to share one message in Edinburgh.
Meanwhile, at a counter-pro-union rally, one person gathered to share 25,000 posts on social media.
Police are investigating the fight that broke out amongst Rangers fans inside Ibrox Stadium after the defeat to Celtic. They wish to interview several rotund men wearing Rangers tops with bald, sunburned heads, red faces and angry expressions. This narrows it down to approximately 38,000 suspects.
And an Aberdeen bar has been named Scotland's Pub of the Year. It's popular with the locals because it has cold beer, great cocktails and a massive TV that shows absolutely zero footage of recent Aberdeen games. Vladimir Putin is to meet Kim Jong-un for arms talks. The venue is expected to be Dr. Evil's underground laboratory or one of Donald Trump's Florida beach houses.
There are concerns that some public buildings in Scotland may have to be demolished.
Holyrood residents want to know if there is any rack in the Scottish Parliament building and, if not, is it too late to put some in?
For now, big thanks, Fiona. T to the H to the A to the N to the K to the S. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Ho, 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 no. Thank you, Martin, indeedy.
No, thank you, Fiona, indeedy, boof. Great to have you figuratively with us. You're watching The Sunday Show. Commence boofing.
Boof!
We're super pumped to be in Scotland for the remake of the classic Scotch movie Highlander. And when it comes to casting, we want to make sure we're getting the best darn talent Scotland has to offer. Get them all on tape. There can be only one to get the lead role.
Up first, Broadway legend Alan Cumming.
There can be only one, two, three, four, gotta sing, gotta dance.
So, next, Peter Capaldi.
There can be only one, okay? Only shambles cluster.
Big Jerry Butler?
There can be only the one, so make it a big one. And can I just say that after Frenchman Christophe Lambert starred in the original Highlander, it's awesomely fantastic that you're seeing an authentic Scottish actor with a true, natural Scottish accent.
I think we agree. There can be only one standout choice to play the lead part in the Highlander remake.
A CGI Sean Connery!
You read my mind.
Commencing synthesized speech, there can be only one.
Bang on. Sir Sean it is.
And the great thing is, Cyber Sean does free promos too.
Highlander the Remake, now streaming on this website.
Right now, in supermarkets all over Scotland this month.
Red hot promotions and frozen prices because we don't have a single clue what time of year it is.
Browse barbecue briquettes and stock up on street grit.
Check out our September combo, sunscreen and antifreeze.
Fill your trolley with ice poles, scotch broth mix, bikinis, thermal joggies, flip-flops and gloves.
Bafflement awaits in your local supermarket seasonal aisle.
See you there.
Some items may not be in stock, some items may stay in stock way past any relevance to Scottish life. But no matter what the weather, rest assured we will always have in stock plenty 32-can discount packs of Pepsi Max. That's just how it is.
This Tuesday, Scotland welcome England in a massive money spinner. I mean, a grand commemorative challenge fixture. For any listeners up for the game from south of the border, here's a completely balanced and unbiased scene-setting preview.
It is 150 years since Scotland met England in the world's first international fixture.
So, FYI, Bedell and Skinner, if football's supposed to be coming home somewhere, it's Glasgow. England have won the World Cup once, but FYI, England haven't won a trophy for 57 years.
Teams other than England who have won something since then include France, Italy, Spain,
the Czechs, Argentina, Brazil,
Germany, Denmark, the Netherlands,
Portugal and Greece.
England have reached the finals of the Nations League since then, but as usual, they lost, and now they have plummeted down the ranks to Nations League Group B.
Unlike Scotland, who are currently in Group A.
England's squad has been hit by withdrawals by Jack Grealish and Trent Alexander-Arnold, maybe injured, possibly scared.
Scotland's squad includes John McGinn, who recently starred in a massive Euro victory for Aston Villa against some team I can't remember, doesn't matter.
So, we welcome the English underdogs to Hampden.
Go easy on us. That was your unbiased preview.
Hiya, I'm Jean Johansson. Join me for tonight's Property Show special, set in Glasgow city centre where dilapidated shopping areas are turned into dream domestic dwellings. Will Adam and Linda choose a flat above a burnt-out nightclub, a vermin-infested ex-office space, or a corner of a clapped-out department store? Find out what they choose in A Place in the Scum.
Don't believe me, just watch.
How are you diddling? If it isn't Sir K-Dog's new Shadow Deputy Prime Minister and Shadow Secretary of State for Levelling Up Housing and Communities, Angela Rayner.
That's me, Anas, and well done for saying it correctly.
Props to you, Angel, for landing that mouthful of a job. You've done a shuffle nearly as groovy as my cha-cha slide. You've more titles than Guardiola, more gigs in Barrowlands. Big Labour are the government in waiting, and you, Renzo, are the PM in waiting. In waiting!
It would be an honour to become the UK's first female Prime Minister, other than those predecessors who shall not be named.
Aha! Mrs. T1, Mrs. T2, Judgment Day, and the Maybot, Oof Day. Anyway, what brings you to Sarwar, Scotia?
It is really, really crucial that we make Labour the party of business again.
I'm all business. In my speech drop, I just said Scottish businesses are pawns in a battle between the SNP and the Tories. Labour can make them better pieces than pawns, like the horsey, the castle or the marge.
The marge.
I've got a Simpsons chess set. Supporting businesses gives the working man more money in a skyrocket to pay for essentials like dentist bills. Under Labour, Scotland's beamers will be gleamers. Hot damn, get glam for the gram.
Now, on to strategy. I understand that Scottish Labour have a new slogan.
That we day. We considered Make Scotland Gallus Again. We thought about Denny Haver, go with Labour. But we've gone for the beezer that is the change that Scotland needs.
Love it. So, what needs to change?
Absolutely hee-haw.
Just unpack that, Amos.
See these pesky gnats? They've been banging on about changing the union since 1919. We're a change for that change.
So, your change is a changeless change?
Exactly, Anjo. Gandhi once said, be the change you want to see in the world. And when we see our world, we didn't want to change it. It's all dandy, Gandhi.
That makes complete sense. Central Labour used the slogan, we're stronger together.
Aye, but we had to change that. It was the change Scotland needs. Hit your hallelujah, Angie. Compliment Sir K-Dog on a smashing shuffle. And tell the boss to floss.
There's no doubting the phrase on everyone's lips this week. Reinforced, autoclaved, aerated concrete.
Right now, all those who use our public buildings like schools and colleges are gathering to check them out and sing about it. This is Rack and Roll. Student life goes on, and not even dodgy construction stops the party.
Oh, what a feeling when we're dancing on the ceiling. Oh, concrete's peeling, now the floor's become the ceiling.
The tunes don't quit, and the lessons must continue, despite the structural state of the school buildings.
We don't need a wrecking ball, stonework falling at the walls. We just wanted to play volleyball, now we're in a shed for pee-pee-pee-pee. A shed for pee-pee-pee-pee.
And even if the acoustics are affected by shoddy structural problems, students still belt out their favourite anthems, updated to fit their current surroundings.
Today is gonna be the day that the roof's gonna fall on you. By now you should have somehow realised you can see right through. I don't believe that any weatherproofing's going on about me now. Cause all the fixtures in this place are crumbling, and all the plans to fix it up are bumbling. There's so many chunks to send, I'm turning black and blue, rubble's in my eye. Cause maybe we're gonna get some decent masonry. Cause after all, it's a rubbish wall.
The greatest hits of Rack and Roll. Bangers that get in your head, dedicated to buildings that do your nut in.
You have been listening to Noising Up, starring Karen Barkey, Stephen Buchanan, Zara Janjua, Lana Faithan and Manjot Sumal. The director was Stuart McPherson. The script was written by Chris Ballard, Tex Winchester, Nathan Cowley, Wes Fargo, Garth Ap Thomas, Uttam Chowdhury, Fergus Kelly, Simon Paul Miller, Rebecca Bain and Alex Garrick-Wright, Paul Brown, Gregor Payton, Zara Gladman and Darren Sempe. Noising Up is a Comedy Unit production for BBC Radio Scotland.